Hey guys, what's up? I'm Rohit from your host Intellect Digest, and today we have with us the Lenovo A7000. In this video, I'm gonna give you a quick unboxing and hands-on review in which I'll talk about the display quality, audio video playback quality. I'll show you camera samples, I'll show you the design, features, specifications, and everything that you need to know about the A7000, including the call quality and all that you need to know about the design and features. Let's get started. The Lenovo A7000 is a large screen 5.5-inch high-definition phone and comes loaded with a lot of specifications for the price. It is priced at only 9,000 rupees and selling exclusively on Flipkart in India. And it is a very well-loaded phone for that price. It comes with 4G LTE support. It comes with a 5.5-inch high-definition display. It comes with powerful set of cameras, including an 8-megapixel rear and a 5-megapixel front-facing camera. And something unique about this phone is that it comes with Dolby Atmos software, which is the surround sound software, which is available only on this phone as of now in the world. There is a screen protector which is included in the box, and first thing that comes out of the box. And next we have the Lenovo A7000, which is here. It says it's a 4G true octa-core or true 8-core phone. It comes with Dolby Atmos and Android Lollipop 5.0 right out of the box, so you need not wait for the updates. Let me keep this aside for a moment and show you what else is in the box, and then we'll come back to the phone. Next, we have some documentations, which includes a quick start guide, some product manuals and warranty manuals. Next, we have a battery, which is a 2900 milliamp lithium-ion battery, which has been bundled with this phone. We have a standard data cable, nothing special about this. This is USB to micro USB. A pair of earphones, and let me show you the quality. These are standard 3.5mm earphones, which come with inline microphone and a headset with a button to accept or reject the calls. And the quality is just about average, nothing special. These are cheap plastic standard earphones, and I would not prefer to use them. I would rather plug some good quality 3.5mm earphones. And this is a wall charger, which looks nice and sturdy. It comes with 1.5 ampere rating. And that's all in the box. Now let me get to the phone and remove everything else from here. And this is the Lenovo A7000. Feels pretty light without the battery. And let me remove this protective plastic from here. It comes with 5.5 inch high definition display, 3 touch capacitive buttons. There is a 5 megapixel front facing and an 8 megapixel rear facing camera, which comes with dual LED flash. There is a secondary mic hole for noise cancellation, speaker grill, Lenovo branding. There are buttons on the right hand side, which includes a power or wake up key and a volume rocker. On top you have the charging port and 3.5 mm audio port. Left side is clean, and on bottom you have the primary microphone hole, which is right here. The phone is nicely finished and comes with a matte finish, which does not attract fingerprints at all. The front of the phone has a slight chin, which is noticeable from this angle. And there is a chin which separates the back shell from the front of the phone. You can open the back shell and you can install your SIM cards and battery here. It includes two SIM cards, which includes a 4G SIM in the SIM card 1. And the SIM card 2 can work only on 2G mode and not on 3G or 4G. So you can put your data SIM on SIM 1 and your secondary SIM, which is used for only calling, in SIM 2. It will not work with the 4G on the second SIM at all. There is a micro SD card slot for expanding the memory, and the battery goes in here. Let me quickly set up this phone, put a SIM card, memory card and boot it up and get back to you. And here we are after quickly setting up the phone, and this is how it greets us. This is a 5.5 inch 720p display, which is very good when it comes to viewing angles as well as color production. It comes with the nice and rich graphics, as well as it's very smooth. It comes with the Vibe UI, which is Lenovo's own proprietary UI. And one thing that you will notice is that it runs the Android Lollipop right out of the box. It has multi-user support, and the software version running here is 5.0, which you can see here. This phone also comes with a system update right out of the box. As soon as I booted it, I got a system update notification, which is somewhere around 9 MB, which means that Lenovo is rolling out regular updates on this phone, which is a good thing. Apart from that, the display quality looks nice. Let me quickly give you a demo video playback just to show you how good the video playback is on this phone, so that you can judge how good this display is for consuming videos as well as watching movies. I'll also turn the volume to maximum so that you can see how loud it is.
I'm Rohit Khurana, host and Click Digest, and this is the retail unit box of the Micromax Canvas Box, and it is also known as Micromax Q380, which has been recently launched, and it is exclusively selling on Snapdeal at 4999 or 5000 rupees. That's a very killer.
So the video playback quality seems nice, and the color production also is good, and you can see that the display quality is fairly good and it's fairly sharp for a 720p display. Now let me play back a quick soundtrack for you so that you can judge the audio quality as well. There's a problem with the design that the speaker is flat on the back, and if you place it on a surface, the sound gets kind of muffled. But if you're not placing it on a flat surface, the loudness is still maintained. It's not the loudest speakers that we have heard in the smartphone segment, but it is clear and the audio is not crackling. It's deep sound and works very nice when it comes to audio playback. When we listen to the same soundtrack on the earphones, it sounds much better and gives a good surround sound, especially with the Dolby digital surround effects on. You can turn it on and off from this top menu here, and you also have a Dolby application which lets you select different equalizers, surround modes, etc., and it gives you a rich and immersive sound experience. It's very good when it comes to sound playback, even with the basic earphones which are provided, and if you plug in good quality earphones, you can enjoy a much better quality sound with this phone. After audio and video quality, let me talk about the camera quality on this phone, which is an 8 megapixel shooter at the rear with dual LED flash and a 5 megapixel front facing shooter. I'll click a few pictures here, and I'll also show you some pictures which I have clicked previously before making this video to show you some quality of shots when taken with light and without light. So these are the shots that I have just taken, and I've used the touch to focus feature here. And in this shot, I have touched on the car, and you can see the car is entirely in focus. While in the other shot, this ball is entirely in focus, and you can see the quality and color production. It's fairly close to natural, and you can see how close it is. Now let me show you a shot which I have taken with the front facing camera. This is a 5 megapixel front facing shooter and comes with some sort of beauty face mode which smoothens the blemishes, etc. The clarity is very clear, however it tends to pixelate if you zoom in too much, but that's not a problem considering that it is a 9000 rupees phone. This is a very good quality from the front facing camera, and also the picture is fairly wide from shoulder to shoulder, and you can accommodate more people in landscape mode when you are taking a selfie. Now this is a picture that I have taken with artificial light, and this is the same picture I have taken without any artificial light, some dimmer lighting. So you can see that there is a slight difference. However, on zooming in with the picture where the light was not sufficient, there is some slight amount of graininess if you look very closely. But it is not that bad. It's a good picture overall for an 8 megapixel shooter. It is a decent camera. It is taking pictures in good quality. This one was clicked in low light where the flash fired, and you can see that there is a kind of off balance when it comes to colors and brightness, which is because of the flash. But the flash is powerful enough and is capable to light up the object fairly well and capture deep details, and there is no graininess when the flash is lighting. This is another shot that I have taken, and this is one more with slightly lower light, and you can see that the darker parts are grainy compared to the brighter parts in the image, which are very sharp and well focused. So this is a good camera in 9000 rupees segment, and I would say that it's not bad when it comes to performance. If you are considering this and comparing this with the phones in 9000 rupees price segment, it is definitely an impressive camera. Talking about performance and gaming, the AnTuTu benchmark, we tested the 64-bit test, and it gave us a score of 42,910, which is again impressive. It comes with a 1.5 GHz true octa-core processor in which all the 8 cores can fire up together, and they are in a stepped mode, so they might be on sleep or they might be working at the same time. It is a MediaTek MTK6752M processor. It comes with 2 GB of RAM, and there is only 8 GB internal memory. out of which 3.1 GB is available for user when you take it out of the box, and that is because it comes with a lot of pre-installed applications which have been put in. I'll quickly show you the storage settings first, and then we'll talk about the applications which come pre-installed. In storage, you can see that there is around 3 GB installed, and we have installed some more applications. So available space is around 3 GB. And one good thing about this phone is that it can change the preferred install location, and you can change it to SD card, which is a very good thing. And you can install apps directly onto the SD card or move apps to the SD card, which is allowed on this phone, which is a welcome thing. Also, it supports USB OTG pen drive. So if you have a USB OTG cable or an OTG pen drive, you can directly connect it and it will be detected, which is a nice thing. And you can always watch movies, etc., off from a third party storage like a USB OTG pen drive, and not worry too much about the storage here. Talking about the extra apps which are installed, there is a games folder which comes with heavy applications and games like the Asphalt 8, Tap the Frog, etc., and there is Green Farm, Spider-Man, Real Football, etc., which are taking up some space. There is UC Browser, Evernote, Navigate, Truecaller, and some applications from Lenovo which include SyncIt, ShareIt, etc., which have been preloaded onto this phone, which is a lot of bloatware in my opinion. So there is a lot of applications which are there which are embedded into this phone which you may not require. You can just go to apps and probably disable these applications which are not needed. For example, I can go to Evernote, and some of the applications can also be uninstalled. For example, if I don't intend to use this, I can simply uninstall it and it will free up some of the space for me, which is a good thing. So they have provided provision to uninstall applications which do not which you do not intend to use much. In terms of graphics performance, we tested it with Neuramark 2 testing utility, and we got a score of 63 frames per second, which indicates that this phone is top notch when it comes to graphics performance. Now, without further wasting any time, let me give you a quick gameplay demo on the Frontline Commando 2, and we are doing a separate gaming video for this phone, so make sure you stay tuned and press the red subscribe button to watch our detailed gaming video. This is just a quick gaming on our quick review video. And also, if you want to purchase one for yourself, I'm leaving some direct links in the description section below where you can pick it up. It will help us if you pick it from there. As you can see, I'm able to play this game very easily. It's very, very precise when it comes to playing this game. It's very easy to control the player. The touch inputs are very precise and the touch screen response is also very good, which makes gaming experience immersive, and also the graphics performance helps making gaming even smoother. Talking about the signal reception and call quality, we are getting full strength 3G signals. We are still not in a 4G zone, so we can't show you the 4G performance, but this phone is receiving good signals when it comes to 3G. And now let me give you a quick call quality test. I'll make a call and place it on speakerphone to give you a fair idea of how loud and clear the audio quality is.
All the options have been changed. Please listen carefully before making a choice.
So this phone is fairly clear when it comes to audio quality in call, and it also comes with two microphones. There is one at the rear and one at the bottom, so it is with noise cancellation so that the other party can also hear you clearly. Now let me show you a quick internet browsing experience by opening our website on the Chrome browser, which comes pre-installed, and we are just gonna type intellectdigest.in, which is our homepage. The keyboard is the Android L keyboard, which is also fairly smooth, and this is loading on 3G, which is Airtel 3G network, and as you can see, it is streaming fairly well. The website is already loaded. It's very, very fast when it comes to the networks, and The scrolling is also fairly smooth, so I am impressed by the way it is performing, and you can very easily pinch and zoom in. The legibility and the quality of display that this phone offers is fairly good. You can see the display clearly, you can pinch to zoom, and the colors pop out really nice. Summing up my first impressions and quick review of the Lenovo A7000, I find it to be a potent phone in 7000 rupees segment. It comes with 4G support, it comes with a beautiful display, it comes with a nice and lightweight construction, it comes with a large battery life, it comes with decent set of cameras, it comes with good audio and video playback, and the Atmos surround from Dolby is also working very well. The signal reception 3G also works fine. We'll come up with more videos talking about details on this phone, so make sure you hit the red subscribe button to get more videos from us. On our first impressions, it is a thumbs up from us. If you want to pick one up for yourself, I'm leaving a direct link in the description section below. If you enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up by pressing the like button below. This is your host Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.